Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos. So hello students, we'll be talking about the further insight of this chapter, the effect of acceleration. As we all know, the piston inside the cylinder is reciprocating, and it is not reciprocating with constant velocity. There is a lot of acceleration involved in it. So what this acceleration has effect on water, we'll see that. How acceleration now affects the head and how it affects everything else, the efficiency, the power output, the work and everything. Now this topic is a very interesting one. We'll see what is the effect of acceleration of piston on the efficiency, the head and everything else. So as we all know, the piston is not is moving with an acceleration. It is not moving with constant velocity. So this acceleration is directly transferred to the water that is being sucked inside the cylinder. So when the piston moves from one end to the other, the extreme left to the extreme right. So suppose the piston is at extreme left and it has to move to extreme right. So it has to gain velocity. For that, it has to accelerate. So the piston starts accelerating. It becomes maximum at certain time, and then again it starts decelerating. So suction stroke is like acceleration become maximum deceleration. And what happens in the delivery stroke is again acceleration becomes maximum deceleration. So this is how it works. Like, so piston is not moving with constant velocity, it is having certain acceleration. That is because of the nature of the single slider crank chain, because of the simple harmonic motion as we know all in physics. So first of all, let's see the displacement, the velocity, how much is the acceleration. Let's calculate the magnitude of acceleration, and then we'll see what is the effect of that acceleration on the head and on the water head. So as you can see, I have drawn only the crank and the connecting rod along with the piston, which is called a slider sometimes. So this is the crank, which is having some angular velocity omega. Now suppose if a crank moves by a certain distance, certain angle I mean, so it will displace the slider by a certain distance. So let's see what that distance is. Suppose initially the crank was horizontal and it has now moved by a certain angle theta. The displacement that it has covered is x. When it was horizontal, this point would have been here. Now it has gained some angle and it has moved through this point, and the linear displacement that it has covered is nothing but x. Now you have to find x. So x is nothing but r minus r cos theta. The total length is r and we have to calculate x. So x is nothing but r minus r cos theta. So you'll get the value of displacement. Now you've got the displacement of the piston, or you can say the piston, instead of piston there will be a slider here in this case. Now you have to calculate the velocity. So we've got the velocity as well. After differentiating displacement, we get the velocity. Now after you differentiate velocity, you get the acceleration. So this is nothing but the acceleration that the piston will be having when it starts moving, or when it will be having motion. This acceleration will be transferred to the water that is being pumped from the suction pipe. So the piston along with the water will be having the same acceleration. So it will be having some acceleration. So now let's see because of this acceleration, what is the effect on the water that is being come, that has been sucked from the inlet side. So we've already calculated the velocity of the piston, the acceleration that the piston will be having, and it is performing a simple harmonic motion. So the velocity equation we know, the acceleration equation we know. So these are the two equations for velocity and acceleration of piston we know. So acceleration is actually comes with negative sign, but we are only interested in the magnitude of acceleration, so let's not worry about the negative sign. Now these two are the velocity and acceleration of piston. Now let's see what is the effect of this velocity and acceleration on the water that is being pumped. So we'll use continuity equation. The water, the amount of water that is coming, the discharge is remaining the same in cylinder as well as in the pipe. So let's equate the discharge at both the end and get some data. So A1, V1, A2, V2 is nothing but area and velocity in the pipe, and A2, V2 is nothing but area and velocity in cylinder. So as you can see here, this small v is nothing but velocity in pipe, and this capital V is nothing but velocity in the cylinder. So we got the value of velocity of water in pipe. So capital A by small a, omega r sin omega t. Now let's see what is acceleration inside the pipe. Now to get the acceleration inside the pipe, you need to differentiate this equation. And after you differentiate this equation, you get so this is the value of acceleration of the water in pipe, A by omega square r cos omega t. Now we got the value of velocity, we got the value of acceleration of the water inside the pipe. Now let's calculate the mass of water that is flowing inside the pipe. To get the mass, it's very simple. Once we get mass, we know acceleration. So let's imagine as the L is the length of the pipe, small a as the area of cross section. So mass of liquid in pipe is nothing but the specific gravity into the area into length divided by g. So this is the mass of liquid in pipe. So we know the mass of liquid in pipe, we know the acceleration. Now let's calculate the force through which it will be moving. Let's calculate the force. An acceleration of water inside pipe we already saw. As you can see, this term acceleration of water in pipe, A by omega square r cos omega t. Now you can write force. This is the force acting on the water that is moving inside the pipe. Now force can be written as pressure into the area. So let's so what I've done here is I've written force as pressure into the area, that pressure inside the suction pipe and the cross section area of the suction pipe. Now this is the pressure. Now let's calculate the pressure head inside the pipe. So pressure head is nothing but pressure divided by rho g, whereas rho g is the specific gravity. So pressure divided by specific gravity will give you the pressure head. So Pa upon rho g is nothing but the pressure head. or we can call it as a suction, the acceleration head. And we all know that omega t is nothing but theta. So this is what you've got here, is nothing but the head because of the acceleration. So since the water is accelerating, and because of acceleration there will be force, because of force there will be pressure, because of pressure there will be pressure head, and this pressure head comes because of acceleration, so we call it as acceleration head. So this is the head that the pump has to overcome, not only HS but also HA that the pump has to overcome to lift the water. So earlier when we saw the indicator diagram, we looked only at HS, which are the height through which it has to be pumped. Now we also came across a new term, HA, which is nothing but the acceleration head, or the head because of the head created because of acceleration. The pump has to overcome this as well. So since you can see here, the head because of acceleration is function of theta, it will be having a varying value at different angles. So let's calculate the value at 0 degree and at other angles. As we know that cos 90 is 0, so HA becomes 0 at 90 degree. So these are the three values of the head because of acceleration at different value of stroke angle. So that was all about the effect of acceleration. The HA, we got a new term, we got a new head, that is the acceleration head, that is only because of acceleration. So it is not only HS that the pump has to overcome, it is also HA. So the value at 0 degree is L by G A by omega square, at 90 degree HA is 0. At 180 degree, HA is minus times L by G A by omega square. So that was all about this topic, effect of acceleration. I hope you've understood this. Now we'll be applying this at different ends and we'll be drawing graph and understanding how it works. So I hope you've understood this much. Thank you so much.